So then maybe what we can do is just to pick our test inputs randomly. So to do what is called random testing. And what that means is that we pick the inputs to test just as we pick a number by rolling a set of dice, randomly. And this will have several advantages. First, we will pick inputs uniformly. So if we use a uniform distribution as the basis for our random testing, we will make no preferences. In other words, all inputs will be considered equal, of equal value. And what that means, in turn, is that random testing eliminates designer bias. So what does designer bias mean? Designer bias is the problem of making the same assumption when we read the specification and we interpret it and when we develop test cases, which means that the developer might develop code assuming a given behavior of the user. And we might write tests making the same assumptions. And the problem, of course, is even worse if it's the same person that develops the code and writes the test cases. With random testing, that problem is gone because we just pick randomly what our inputs will be. So why not doing random? The problem is that when testing, we are looking for a needle in a haystack. Actually, multiple needles in multiple haystacks, if we want to be precise. So random approaches are not necessarily the best way to go about it because we might just be looking in all the wrong places. So let me show you this using a different representation for the haystack. What I'm showing here is a grid, and imagine this grid just expanding indefinitely outside the screen. And this grid represents the domain for the program. So each box in the grid, each square in the grid, it's a possible input. So what happens with bugs is that bugs are very scarce in this grid. Maybe there is a bug here. So that means that there is a bug that an input in this point will reveal. And maybe there is another bug that will be triggered by an input over here. So imagine this spread out over this infinite grid. It's very unlikely that just by picking randomly, we will be able to get to these two points. Fortunately, not all is lost. There is a silver lining. So we need to look a little in more depth into this grid.